country. We killed ISIS leader al-Baghdadi.
He's dead. He's dead as a doornail. And he didn't die bravely either.
I will tell you that. He should have been killed years ago. Another president should have gotten him. But to me, it was a very important, I would say all the time, they'd walk into my office, sir, we killed this leader at a low level, this leader at, I said, I never heard of him. I want al-Baghdadi. That's the only one I know now. I want al-Baghdadi. Get him. And they got him.
And I bet they love walking in and telling you who they get. That was the president, still on a personal victory tour far, far, far away from Syria. Again, reflecting on the raid that killed ISIS leader Baghdadi, even while reporting in multiple news organizations, indicates that he may have done more to hinder the operation than help it. From the New York Times, quote, Mr. Trump's abrupt withdrawal order 3 weeks ago disrupted the meticulous planning underway and forced the Pentagon to speed up the plan for the risky night raid before their ability to control troops, spies, and reconnaissance aircraft disappeared, with the pullout, officials said. While Baghdadi's death in the raid on Sunday, they said, occurred largely in spite of and not because of Mr. Trump's actions. Richard Haass, the president of the Council on Foreign Relations, put an even finer point on it. Quote, the irony of the successful operation against Baghdadi is that it could not have happened without U.S. forces on the ground that have been pulled out, without help from Syrian Kurds who have been betrayed, and support of a U.S. intelligence community that has so often been disparaged. Now, while the raid was obviously a welcome success, the conditions that made the operation possible may not exist in the future. Joining the table, Democratic strategist Basil Smigel, and in Washington, Kevin Barron, executive editor of Defense One. Kevin, I want to ask you about that New York Times reporting and read you a little bit more from it. American officials said the Kurds continued to provide information to the CIA on Baghdadi's location even after Mr. Trump's decision to withdraw the American troops left the Syrian Kurds to confront a Turkish offensive alone. The Syrian and Iraqi Kurds, one official said, provided more intelligence for the raid than any single country. I know people like you know this sort of at a cellular level, just how close the Kurdish-American military and intelligence relationship is. But can you describe the significance of this operation carried out over the weekend after Donald Trump made the decision to cut and run on them?
Sure. You know, I think everyone is highlighting that it just means, once again, Trump made an announcement that something was going to happen in Syria, and it's not exactly what's happening. So this was supposed to be a small pullout from the north, and then it was going to be a total pullout from the whole country, and then it was going to be, well, we're going to have at least some troops in the region to fight ISIS, and now we're going to have also additional troops that we're going to send back in to hold and protect the oil field locations in the east of Syria. But this was different. Today General Milley said was about 4 miles from the border of Turkey. So it's right in the region and right up there against what we've all been talking about for 2 weeks. It does show, I think, that long term, I think things are settling a bit. And the sense that I'm getting and what we're hearing even from the field is that the Kurds know there's a difference between what Donald Trump is saying and what America might do. They know that there's a longer game to play. The Kurds have been playing it for decades with regard to their own independence and autonomy and relationships. And they're going to forge whatever relationships that they can to, you know, protect themselves. And so I can understand that while, you know, Trump made his announcement and you know, everyone is writing rightfully about U.S. abandonment of the Kurds in the region, at the same time, the Kurds were sticking with the operators and the commanders on the U.S. side who have been with them this whole time for something as sensitive and as high valuable as Baghdadi. I mean, we had an interview today with overnight with the leader of the Women's Fighting Force, the YPJ, an exclusive interview, and she said that, you know, they worked also with the Americans to help ahead of time with the mission, that they also viewed it as a win, not just, you know, for them, but for women everywhere that Baghdadi was killed, and that they're going to continue the fight.
You know, Basil, I think what's so stunning is that in the reporting 24 hours after the successful raid, and we should all take every opportunity to praise the military and intelligence professionals and our allies and the Kurds that Kevin's talking about, who play a long game, sure, as he's pointing out. But you also have to stop and listen to what he's saying. He's saying that even the Kurds, our allies thousands of miles away, know that Donald Trump's words don't carry the weight of the United States government. That's amazing.
It is amazing, and I can certainly understand why they feel that way. But speaking about words, I actually often go back to Maya Angelou's comments. I'm going to paraphrase her here. I may not remember what you said or what you did, but I remember how you made me feel. And if I think about the way in which Donald Trump delivered the message that this operation was successful, and he listened to the cheers of the folks in that room, what I wonder is, will anybody really care at the end of the day his maneuver to pull American forces out and the Kurds still standing with us, or will they just remember that speech that he just gave? For me, you know, obviously I focus on the fact that he did withdraw troops, the fact that he did in the same speech go after Obama needlessly, right? I focus on that, but I wonder if the average sort of voter, average Republican that's still on the fence, not sure if they want to be with him, if their only takeaway from this was the way in which he delivered that message the other day.
You know, Betsy, I lapped up all of the reporting in every news organization about how they kept this secret. It seemingly some of the timing even from him, but that how they had to accelerate the timing because of his decision. I mean, he really has, and take whatever metaphor you want, he really has affected everything, even the pursuit of one of America's most wanted terrorists.
That's right. Another piece of this that's important is that it's been reported that some of the intelligence that the United States used to put together this raid was human, which means it came from people who trusted Americans and shared information with them. People in the intelligence community say our capabilities of gathering and cultivating that type of intelligence have waned. And to the extent that folks feel that they can't trust the Americans they're working with, and that people within the CIA and the other intelligence agencies have a lack of confidence in Washington, those capabilities are in a tough spot under this administration.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.